in an elimination match. One of these teams is going home. This is the closest we've seen Northern Gaming to dropping out this early in the tournament. They have finished third in both seasons one and two. Here, they are need to make quite the run in the lower bracket to pull it off again.
And is it because they're missing Maestro, one of their key players? The Remco Maestro duo is something we always talk about. They're iconic in the European scene. But right now, Maestro is not here. He's been replaced by another great player, Turbo Pulsa. But again, if it's not the player that you played all season with, not the player that you've kind of glued together with, it's going to be a bit of a struggle because you're not going to have that confidence.
That synergy between Remco and Maestro, something we've been talking about for three seasons now, and it's not here on the pitch. This dynasty of Europe, of Northern Gaming, they're in flux right now. What are they going to do? How will they perform? We will find out as this match gets underway. But the Canadians on the other side, can they pull off the upset here against the European dynasty? I'm excited to see how it's going to go. How do you think it's going to go, Carmen?
Hard to say, man. Denial. A lot of people kind of speculated, should they be here? They are the Slayers of G2, a team that we expected to be here. Denial was the team to finally cut them out of LAN. But we have seen them struggle a bit. I haven't really seen anything from them that's crazy impressive, but they definitely have grown on me. They seem to have been improving from game one yesterday. We'll see what they can do against Northern Gaming.
It would be very impressive if Denial was able to knock out two teams in one day. But after knocking out Selfless, we'll see how they perform against Northern Gaming. It is Northern Gaming in the blue, Denial in the orange, as we get set here on DFH Stadium. Corrupted hanging out on the opponent's side of the pitch while the ball is in his territory. Two goalies have to go up on the side of Denial to block it out. Now Devo out to Remco, a follow-up shot. Quickly, NRG scores here in game one.
The moment Devo saw this double dedication, he knew he had to get it back center as fast as possible. Look at that touch. He could have potentially waited and gotten the boost as well, but he knew he had little time to make sure he put it to the center. Beautiful touch from him and an even beautifuler. I'm going to do it.
More beautiful.
No, beautifuler follow-up by Remco.
Setting up, reading the ball as it bounces out of the corner is difficult enough. To properly hit the ball to create that bounce out of the corner, very impressive play from Devo to set it out to Remco. They will get the first point here in game number one of our best of five. Loser goes home. It'll be Turbo now, back to Devo. They'll be able to press this one into the orange corner once more. Devo with another setup here. Remco looking for the finisher, but Lethemir with the clear. And it'll be Turbo Pulsa who follows it into the blue corner. They'll wait this one on the wall. Bait in Sad Jr. Lethemir immediately in with the follow-up. Can he get it out here? It's going to go farther than Corrupted G was ready for. Turbo Pulsa with the follow-up. Will it go? No! Sad Jr. able to block it at the last possible moment. We'll stay at 1-0.
Four shots already for Northern Gaming against the one from Denial. They seem to be snuffed out right now, stuck on defense. They need to try and gather it up and see if they can move it to offense quickly.
Three players back on defense for Denial. Lethemir moves out. Krupji came in behind after the touch. Back in from Northern Gaming. From Devo to try. Put it through Sad Jr., but he has the read on the wall. Ball bounces around the corner. Now Turbo Pulsa uncontested. Back across midfield. Corrupted G with the long clear. Double demolition here upon the pitch. That'll leave it at 2v2 for just a moment. But now Remco down to the corner. The kill from Corrupted G just dies on his hood. Ends up back out. Remco with a shot off the corner. Double commitment to clear it away, but low enough that both players immediately regain car control. And Devo to try to drop that one through. Did not have the angle correctly. But so much pressure right now from Northern Gaming. Turbo Pulsa in the air so early to put that off the backboard. Sad Jr. over the top of Devo. And Remco, Lethemir right there in front. The cherry picked from Lethemir. Playing so far upfield. Denial looking for the quick transition goal right now.
Oh my, the pass from Remco. You can see the panic from Denial. A lot of double dedications on defense. They're trying to turn it around quickly. They seem to be getting a bit faster on the transition from defense to offense.
That demolition on Lethemir will relieve some pressure, but it doesn't matter. Corrupted G finds a way through the defense by himself, ties up the game.
Didn't expect this follow-up from Corrupted G to be so confident. Devo couldn't get it off the wall. Remco trusted his teammate just a bit too much. Corrupted G saw the hole and was able to sink the shot in.
Devo missing on the wall. Spells a tie game here. About halfway through. Remco to try and set it off the ceiling, but no follow-up. There's Turbo Pulse with a shot towards the net, cleared by Corrupted G. Lethemir into the corner. Devo sets it off the wall once more. Remco in with a follow-up shot. Lethemir with the save. Defense from Denial, keeping us at a tie game. Sad Jr. now to play that one back across midfield. pinch and go laterally. Other side of the field now, still in the mid. Demo lets that one move all the way to the corner. Sad Junior plays it out. Back and forth right now between these two teams. Both teams playing safe, not wanting to get punished by more defensive mistakes. Denial's holding on, though the ball is spending so much time in their half right now.
It really is. Northern Gaming nearly doubling their shots. 9 shots for Northern Gaming and 5 for Denial. It seems that whenever Northern Gaming does have control, they're able to continue it for so long.
Lethemir clearing that one. Very crucial. Turbo Pulsa was already airborne, ready to finish it off on the pass from Devo. Devo now in net. No cut in front of Turbo Pulsa. Get bumped a little bit. Try and push himself out of that corner. A demo into Turbo Pulsa. This gives Denial the power play. Lethemir fakes him out. Corrupted G. All he has to do is put it in. He does. Denial has the lead.
Both of these goals have been a little unorthodox, but I can't say much. A demolition from Lethemir followed by a fake. I think that was more of a missed. Lethemir really dedicated to that. When you see the second flip, generally he really wanted to get that touch, but he didn't get it, forcing Devo up. Couldn't get back down quick enough. And now in the lead, game number one, Denial.
That's 2 misses from Devo. The second one, not as much of a mistake and more of just being juked out by the Denial players. So far, defensive lapses there. Going to be giving Denial the lead here in game number one. Final minute here on DFH. Turbo Pulsa lofts that one high. Devo to try and get in, but misses the touch. Goes underneath Sad Junior. Denial will be able to keep pressure in the enemy territory. Corrupted G now onto the backboard. Does not have the second touch as Turbo Pulsa takes it away from him. Devo on the spider position will be able to play that one long across the field. Lethemir in the back to sweep it out. Out to Corrupted G. He'll take another shot towards the net, and Turbo will save it. We'll stay at a 1-goal differential. Turbo Pulsa doing everything he can to keep this lead from extending for Denial. But right now, the defense will not win Northern Gaming. They have to get the goal.
This has really been a Denial game for the second half of this. They have now tied it up. 9 shots to 9 shots. Northern Gaming hasn't been able to get a single shot on net.
Oh, Devo to Remco. Off the crossbar, brought up Lethemir. And Corrupted G, the correct positioning, gets the block and puts it away. They'll keep the pressure on here, but there's Lethemir on the wall, taking it away, reversing the direction of the rotation. Now, 1 second remaining. The ball will touch Denial against all odds, taking game number one here against Northern Gaming.
They're playing to their strengths. They're trying not to overcommit, and there were a lot of times that you saw a lot of the Denial players in a full-on panic on defense, but they were still able to do it. Look at how many saves that is. 8 saves for Denial. Ended up with 9 shots as well. Tying, was that 9?
Yes, 4 plus 4 plus 1.
And then eventually 12 shots from Northern Gaming. Mm-hmm. So they were able to get a few more. I guess I miscalculated that. I mean, that's the math, North American math.
Dude, there's so much offensive pressure on both sides of the ball, but it was kind of the save game here. Northern Gaming doing as much as they could. Turbo Pulsa with a savior medal himself, topping the board here as far as personal score for Northern Gaming. The sub playing very, very well, but not enough here as Denial was able to get the win. We'll move into game number two. Northern Gaming down.
It really just seems like they haven't been able to find their groove with Turbo Pulsa. They're a little bit slower. They're a little bit sluggish. They're not finding each other as much. We're not seeing the pairs working together, even with a sub. We're not seeing Remco and Devo working together, or Devo and Turbo. I mean, no matter what pair, they're just kind of lobbing it out and hoping to outplay, which they were able to do a few times. But it seems that Denial are playing to their strengths. They're not overcommitting. They're trying to just play defense until Northern Gaming pushes a bit too hard. And then they're getting a lot of good counterattacks.
Well, and the thing we heard from Denial in their interviews was they love to bump. They love to interrupt and be a nuisance in the midfield. We see that so much. A team that relies on passing as much as Northern Gaming does, that nuisance style of play where you're up and in their grill and breaking up the pass plays is going to really hard counter you. So right now, Northern Gaming has to be able to adapt on the fly. They have to be able to create pressure. They have to create some sort of personal clutchness. They need to be able to shoot and not rely on their teammates to be there, because right now, Denial is doing everything they can to break up the passing plays. Here's Devo in the corner to try and loft this one for Turbo, but he'll back off to Sad Junior in the air, zones him out. This will give the ball back to Denial. Game two set to go here on Manfield. It's Denial in the lead by 1. Turbo Pulsa in the corner, trying to wrap around. Corrupted G takes a shot. Devo won't get there. The pace that Corrupted G puts on it gives them the lead again here in game number two.
Following up to this closely, that first one getting contested by Sad Junior. Devo or Remco, neither were back. I wonder how they got caught off so much. There may have been a bump that I didn't see off camera. Both of them so out of position. You had to know that was going to get contested. Sad Junior had a lot of momentum coming up to that.
And the lead in the series by 1, and now in the lead in the game by 1, Denial. in full control as Northern Gaming has their hands full with the Canadians. Corrupted G sets that one out to Sad Jr. They'll play it downfield. Lethemir in the air. Does he make contact? Doesn't need it. Sad Jr. makes it a 2-goal game.
What on earth right now is happening with Northern Gaming? They just can't seem to do much. Devo putting that out towards the center, towards no one. Remco and Turbo bailing on that play. Essentially, you want one to stay at midfield and one to try and go up for the pass from Devo, but no one was expecting it, and it left a wide open net for Denial.
4:17 left to go. We're not out of the first minute, and Denial is already up 2-0 over this European dynasty. Devo to try and drop it down. He had the setup, but he misses wide. And they'll try to keep this ball in the orange, but the positioning from Denial is going to be too much. They'll be able to press it back into the blue and put it right there in front of the net. If there had been anybody sitting in front of the box, that would have been a third goal for the Canadians. Right now, we'll see Northern Gaming press back into the orange. I believe it was Turbo Pulse. They're going for the bump and net. Devo again missing just wide of the goal, just off the crossbar there. Bit of an accuracy plaguing Northern Gaming right now. They have had the opportunities to score and have not capitalized.
Yeah, and they're now trying to play smart and calculated. They want to make sure they're in the right positions as the ball's coming their way. That fence may have been dangerous, but again, no one following up from Northern Gaming. Devo trying to cut that off.
Oh, Turbo pulls an open net. He won't miss this one. He'll put that one in. The sub player coming in and getting Northern Gaming on the board.
That gives Northern Gaming a bit of room to breathe. Now only a 1-goal game with 3:22 left. Devo cut that off at the source, trying to stop that passing play. It seemed that Denial got a little bit too comfortable right there.
3:22 left to go here. Game number two, Denial still with a 1-goal lead. Northern Gaming looking to bounce back after dropping game number one. Offensive pressure in their favor, but then Denial with the zone from Lethemir. Turbo Pulse looks at the demo into Sad Jr. This opens up space for Remco to move down the field. He's got Devo in support to try and put that one through, but Corrupted G able to block it out. Get it back to Lethemir. Him and Sad Jr. are going to be moving out together. Corrupted G lurking in the midfield, gets dunked by Devo. Over to the side, but no follow-up from Northern Gaming. They will not be able to capitalize. Ball stays in their half.
Northern Gaming seems to be picking up the pace now, trying to shut out a lot of these pushes from Denial Esports.
Devo will let that one doink off the top of them. They'll be able to roll this one back around in front of the net. A miss from Sad Jr. gives an opportunity. I believe it was Devo was not expecting that to happen. He had already fallen back. Respect from these teammates. These players not gonna assume anybody making mistakes right now. Remco plays that one away. Devo, what a touch in the midair. Can Turbo Pulse to finish this off? He drops it in, but Sad Jr. steals it away. The beautiful transition shut down by the veteran, and Denial holds on to the lead.
If they can keep this up, they might be a bit starved right now. Denial might be a bit panicked. It's gonna drop back down. Sad Jr. misses it. It's wide open. Can Devo get there?
He'll shoot through. That's a tie game.
They now bring it back. 2 minutes left. It's a tie game. Turbo Pulse turning around the moment Sad Jr. wasn't able to reach it. I figured they were getting starved for boost. An amazing touch from Devo to start that off from his half all the way towards the net.
That's a few times now we've seen Denial miss the clear in the air. I believe Northern Gaming, they believe if they can leave some offensive pressure right in front of the net, they could easily come back into this and capitalize on those mistakes repeatedly. Remco setting this one out to Devo. He'll drop it down, but Sad Jr. pops it up. Devo puts it back down into the box, and Corrupted G will get a clear, but still the pressure put on again by Northern Gaming. That's two players out of goal. Devo takes a shot, and Sad Jr. in with the block. They'll keep the game tied up, but right now, Remco and company are starting to build momentum, Carpet.
And I think they're figuring out the moment you put a lot of pressure on the Nile, they really do panic. All three again.
All three, Turbo
grouping
open
up.
Can he put it through? He does, and that's Northern Gaming with the lead.
That's pretty much the fourth time in a row we saw all three Denial players just clumping up in the corner of the net. They really need to be careful. With no momentum, you're not going to clear that through. That was fortunate for Turbo, I will say. Bouncing right back into him.
He's like, okay, thank you. Appreciate that one. Don't need to have another one. But he was also, for the 5 seconds or so leading up to that, just sitting there lurking in front of the box, waiting for those mistakes. As we said, if they can continue just to capitalize on these defensive mistakes, Denial will find themselves down in the series, and Northern Gaming will be able to tie it back up. Right now, Denial with some pressure in the blue half. It'll get cleared out by the air. Northern Gaming gonna push this one back through. Lethemir into the mid. Corrupted G turns quickly, but Turbo pulls it over the top of him back into the orange box. And it'll be Devo through Lethemir, winning the 50-50. The drag race on the side gives it to Remco around the corner in front of the box. No pressure through again. Northern Gaming now starting to play a bit more defensively. They have the lead. We're in the final minute. Do not want to concede this here at the end. Just do not make the defensive mistakes Denial's been making, and they'll be able to finish this one off. 35 seconds left. It's all they got to do to be able to tie up the series.
Northern Gaming initially down by two. They've gotten three unanswered goals. They may have figured out what it takes to put the pressure onto Denial.
Oh, three players from Northern Gaming tangled up in the corner. This is bad news. Denial might be able to put it through here and tie it back up. Turbo pulls it high, but Corrupted G in the air. He should be able to drop this in. He does. It's tied up.
They keep it tied up. They've done it right back in return. Two going for that. Turbo knows he had to get that to make the shot harder on Corrupted, but it doesn't matter for him. Corrupted still with the accuracy and was following through as well. If it was a weak block, he would have easily secured the goal.
The last two goals both involve the entire defensive squad being grouped up on one side. And here you see it favoring Denial as we are tied in game number two. Basically, next goal takes the game. Can Northern Gaming bounce back into the series? They're going to try to do it in regulation as it drops down, gets cleared away. Overtime in game two.
Sorry, Shogun, but boys and girls, this is a real game.
Oh, it is a real game. Next goal pulls it off. The crowd cheering for the Canadians here. Wanted to see them pull it off and shake the dynasty of Northern Gaming. Knock them out early in day two. Sad Jr. coming in from the back. Northern Gaming with an opportunity, but Lethemir back into the midfield. Turbo pulls it in, taking a shot. Lethemir with a clear again. Corrupted G stays grounded this time. No double commitment. It's what Denial has to do to keep themselves alive here in game two. Devo in the air to try and drop it through.
But
does it go? It's Turbo
pulls
it. What a read to know where the defenders would be. Northern Gaming ties the series.
Just watch how Devo follows through with this. He gets the first touch and knows to keep his wheels on it to try and stuff out that clear. Turbo pulls it, reading his teammate. 30 seconds into overtime, 4-3. Northern Gaming tie up the series.
I mean, how do you read that? There were two defenders on the ground and your teammate falling from the heavens, and you'd be like, it's gonna bounce off him and then off this hood, and it'll be, hey, let's go, let's aim there. Okay, cool, cool, GG, got
the
game.
You know how you read that? You be Devo.
Be Devo.
Just be Devo.
Be Turbo Pulsa.
Turbo Pulsa, 4 goals.
4 goals, all the goals.
12 shots and 4 goals for Northern Gaming. Only 6 shots for Denial. They really snuffed him out, but it was only a 1-goal game. Northern Gaming seemed to have figured out, though, if you put a lot of pressure on the Nile, their defense just falls apart. Way too many times that game than I was comfortable with. Did we just see everyone in Denial just piling into net?
To be clear, it's 12 shots for Northern Gaming total, not 12 shots for Turbo Pulsa, which would be absurd.
I'm excited.
He got 6, and then there was 6 from Devo. Remco, considerably quiet this game, only 1 assist on the stat sheet, coming in with 150 points. So maybe this would be part of what, if Remco were to be able to step up and be playing at the toy level that Devo and Turbo Pulsa were that game, we see a bit more convincing of a win here, as Denial had them on the ropes for the entire game, tying it up right there at the end at 17 seconds. Denial playing like a different team here against Northern Gaming, and we'll go into the third game tied up in the series.
Now, Denial started off that game strong, up 2 goals. But Northern Gaming were able to get 3 unanswered to take the lead and put the pressure on top of them. So will they be able to clench this out? And remember, this is an elimination game.
Yes.
Whoever loses this is done. RLCS Season 3.
This match, sending somebody home. In Game 3 here, we're guaranteed at least a Game 4. So it takes 3 wins to pull off the match win. Sad Jr. on the wall here. Starting to set it up for Lethemir. Turbo will clear it away. Devo loses the contestant there on the side. Remco now in the corner with Corrupted G and Lethemir. It's like 4 players in the corner. Sad Jr. will sweep in from the side, try to put it on the wall. Remco back down. Sad Jr. going for the bump on Devo in net, creating some confusion. Corrupted G might have a shot here. It'll go through. That interference created by Sad Jr. gives Denial the lead.
1 shot, 1 goal. Lethemir following that through was huge for him. Devo thought he had the read, but Lethemir made sure that he got the next touch around Devo, and that just threw all of Northern Gaming's defense for a loop.
4:32 left to go. Denial again scoring early. Had 2 goals in the first minute. Game number 2. Corrupted G now. Went out the kickoff, but handed the ball control back to Turbo Pulsa. Devo will now put it into the corner, and Northern Gaming is going to look to get set up on offense. Remco onto the backboard. Turbo Pulsa had the rotation, but just did not trust himself on the wall. Falls down and then misses the touch on the ground. This gives presence and ball control over to Denial. The ball lofts into the middle. Remco will get there first. Repigi to play to the side, interrupt Turbo Pulsa's touch. He'll play across the midfield. Devo in the back. backs off as well. Right now, Northern Gaming not feeling confident on the walls, and Denial is making use of that.
They might be, but they have to be careful. Ledomir just getting there in time, and they might have the lead now. But remember, last game, they could not hold it.
Turbo Pulse in the midfield. RPG to put it high on the wall. Devo off the side. Remco back into the middle, and Turbo Pulse airborne after the pass. Onto the backboard. Ledomir is there, clears it off to the side.
They know better than to let that go.
Ledomir on the side now, in the corner with Remco. Zed Jr. rotates into goal. Three players for Denial rotating out. Looking to apply offensive pressure. Ledomir in the corner looking to set up his teammates, but Devo takes it away from him, gets it past Zed Jr. as well. Now all three players facing backwards for Denial. RPG just hits it to the side, just tries to buy time while the rotations get set up. Remco going to create the confusion. Turbo pulls it in with the shot. It goes off the post. The inaccuracy going to keep us with Denial in the lead by one.
At least they know they have the opportunity, but they need to make sure they clean up those shots at this moment. Facing, getting knocked out, they really need to be careful.
Turbo Pulsa taking a shot towards the net, saved by Sad Jr., but Remco in, puts another shot on target. Turbo Pulsa with the redirect right in front of the net. We've got a tie game.
And there it is, good old Tururu following it up. This touch from Remco, beautifully dropped down. I cannot believe he trusted him to get that touch. I don't know what possessed Turbo to be there for it.
A beautiful touch too, because Sad Jr. was right there to save it. And put that one away. We've got a tie game. We've got a tie series. These teams neck and neck right now. Neither one wanting to be the third team out here at LAN. Sad Jr. gonna send this one high. Ledomir up for the follow through. He does not make contact, and Devo will clear it away. They'll look to transition quickly. Devo up in a cherry pick position. Might be able to set up Turbo Pulsa here. And three players again for Denial tangled up in the corner. Remco misses on the wall, and Ledomir will be able to break free. He gets it past Devo, but Turbo Pulsa in from the side will clear it away, and we'll reset here with the ball in the midfield.
Denial really impressing me. Their counterattacks are really something to worry about. It seems that that's how they really
Remco off the top, puts it in and gets the lead.
They seem to be waking up. Now this is the Northern Gaming that we have seen before. Devo faking everyone out and then Remco just beating out Corrupted G. That was definitely faster than 62 miles an hour. I think it hit the crossbar just before it went in.
Just a little bit, taking a bit of speed off of it. Remco, the laser beam, gives the lead back to Northern Gaming. Devo now in the corner, out towards Turbo, over the top of Corrupted. Sad Jr. in the mid, keeping that pressure on. Remco will come off the wall. Try and push it back out. This is three players in the midfield right now for Northern Gaming. Devo's falling back, waiting for the touch. He's actually going to turn around again. Just not trusting, not convinced that his best position was to be somewhere. Nice fake there over the top of Sad Jr., but Corrupted G's got him. Ledomir might be able to finish this off, but it's Remco sending it away back to the corner. Though to push this one back out, Denial still looking to tie it back up.
1.5 minutes left. Can Denial get this? It seems that they really seem to capitalize on counterattacks, so they need to wait for a Northern Gaming drive to try and push it back.
Remco back into the middle. It'll be Turbo Pulsa and Devo on the side here. Remco way upfield, but misses contact. Could have extended the lead there with a precise shot from the corner. Turbo Pulsa, does it go in? No, it goes off the top. The bump from Denial onto themselves. Can Corrupted G make the save? He does. The savior medal for the Canadian, but Devo in with the follow-up. Another one as they send it away. Corrupted G with the clear. Denial's holding on, keeping it at the one-goal game. Such a critical scoreline as we are within the final minute. They want to be able to use that zero time to be able to tie up the game.
And this is when Denial breaks down. I think this drive could be yet another goal for Northern Gaming. They seem in control. Turbo trying to take that off the wall. Devo trying to support.
Ledomir misses in the midfield. Remco will keep the pressure on in the corner. Devo with the shot towards the net. Turbo watching for his opportunity. He'll try to kill it, but Ledomir immediately picks it up. Passes to Corrupted G, and Turbo pulls it. Interferes. It's going to drop. Can he finish it off? No. Remco watching, just being a threat in the corner. The time game favors Northern Gaming right now, but Corrupted G gets it past Devo. He'll pass to the midfield for Sad Jr. Trying to kill it around more. The plays are coming through, but Turbo Pulsa shuts it down. Back into the corner. Final countdown. If they can hold on to this, Northern Gaming will go up in the series. But Sad Jr. down the field. Nobody in the play. Nobody around the ball right now. Devo will just look to kill it in the corner. Northern Gaming takes the lead.
Northern Gaming now one game away from staying alive. Denial facing elimination. I'm really impressed by them, though. A team that I think everyone underestimated coming into this. They were the number 4 seed in North America. I wasn't horribly impressed by a lot of what they showed throughout league play, but they seem to have really brought it out now. The moment you think they're falling apart, the moment you see their defense group up, as soon as they gain control, they flip it right back on. They spread out, they get into their positions, and they have phenomenal counterattacks.
Yeah, right now, we see Denial. They're keeping it very, very close with Northern Gaming. It's never without of reach. Well, they have that one, just a one goal lead. They can keep the ball in the air as soon as time expires and still tie it up and send us to overtime. They're doing a good job keeping that victory within reach, but they have not been able to do it for two games now. And they were held to just three shots here in game three compared to the 11 from Northern Gaming, who has just been putting up a monster show of offense right now. They have to be able to get the ball into Northern Gaming's territory and keep it there for an extended period of time.
And the most threatening plays we saw from Northern Gaming were ones where they were able to just continue for so long. They had the boost starving. They were able to get shots. Turbo felt confident enough to take really weird touches off the sidewall. Mm. But you know you can pull that off when you've taken all their boost. You know they can't contest it. Mm-hmm. You might as well take the risky play and try and center it for your teammate.
Yeah, and Remco really stepping up there in game number three, comes out as the MVP of that match and has had plenty of points, a goal, plenty of shots. We will see if he's able to continue it here in game four. A win here sends Northern Gaming on and sends Denial home. But Denial, a win, will send us to the critical game five. I'm excited to see how this one will pan out. We've just gone, so we were on DFH, and then we were on Manfield, and we went back to DFH, and it was raining, and we were like, let's go away. And then we went to Manfield. Now it's still raining again.
I actually don't know the names of any of these fields by just looking at them. I just don't put them to memory. I just go by the way they look.
You are a professional Rocket League commentator.
I mean, yeah.
Lethemir, can he do it here? Sad Jr. was in support, but did not see an opportunity. Turbo Pulse shuts that one down on him. Remco looking for the back pass to Devo in the corner. Repto G will take the shot. Turbo Pulse blocks it away. Denial, they need this win so desperately. A loss here sends them home for season three. Right now, trapped in their own corner. RLCS will slow this one down. Pass to Sad Jr. Shot down the middle. It'll go in and Denial's up.
Yet another counterattack. It is Denial's strength right now. The moment they see that they pushed up too much, Devo the last line of defense. Remco trying to drop back, but Sad Jr. putting the pace on that shot.
That is three games in a row now that Denial has scored first. And yet, the first two games they were not able. The last two games they did not come out with the win. They will need to put the pressure on, put the points on, and keep Northern Gaming trapped in their own half. Do not give them the opportunities to tie this up. Sad Jr., another blazing shot. Turbo Pulsa saves it away. And Lethemir misses on the follow-up touch. This gives Turbo Pulsa the 1v1 against Corrupted G. He has follow-up from Remco. It's tied up.
Baiting him in, Turbo Pulsa, knowing it was going to be a difficult shot. He didn't really have a lot of time to bait it, so instead he just wanted Corrupted to try and make a save. He goes off the backboard instead, knowing Remco would follow through.
3:55 left to go. Tie game. Game number four. Turbo Pulse and Sad Jr. going on kickoff. Devo will ultimately win out. Puts it into the orange corner. Follow up from Remco. Lofted high. There was no follow up from Devo, so that left it for Denial. Sad Jr. will kill this one. Denial will look to set up more efficiently. Corrupted G in the midfield. That one gets cleared entirely over the entire squad. Can Devo set this one out? He does not make contact on the wall, but there's Remco out to Turbo Pulse. So the shot towards the net. Three players committed, but nobody in this orange corner means the Sad Junior's alone with ball control. He can push this back out to the blue. We'll see if Lethemir can keep it going. He does, as we'll see Denial with an opportunity to score.
Even if they don't have full control, that did buy them time to get boots. Will Devo drop this down? He goes for the ceiling touch instead. Oh man, look at how fast Northern Gaming is playing now.
Lethemir. Back out. The scoring opportunity shut down as both Denial players had fallen back into their own box. What a shot there from Devo. Turbo pulls it in to try and redirect it around. Does not make enough contact to put it into the goal, but Northern Gaming keeps the pressure on. There's Turbo Pulsa on the side, coming for a round. He'll try to set it out for Remco. It's lofted in the middle. Two players miss again. Corrupted G, also a soft touch there. We'll see Northern Gaming hold on to ball control. Big win we saw here from Northern Gaming involved just punishing massive mistakes from Denial. To keep that pressure on, they will easily send the Canadians packing. But Denial, not wanting to be sent quietly into the night, will continue to fight here in game four, all tied up as we have across halftime.
Northern Gaming wants to try and put this next one in. This is so close for them. They have a control.
Oh, Turbo! The whole team doesn't matter, does it himself, and he's got the lead.
Turbo coming and showing he's not just a sub, he's an amazing player. What a dribble from him, taking everyone from the Nile out. He must be shining right now.
Oh my goodness. Can you say power sub? Can you say starter at this point?
Sorry, Maestro.
Yeah. Have to go get some new shoes. Oh my goodness, Remco, another mind game to play this one downfield. He and Sad Jr. in the corner. Lethemir rotates in. It'll be Corrupted G, last man in goal. Two players up again, and not a very solid touch to clear it away. Turbo Pulsa will keep the pressure on. Devo with the setup around. See Remco lurking on the side. So he can set it up. Turbo in the mid. He's sharking right now. He's pulling a Cookster, just waiting for the opportunities to score, as he has been a machine here. Turbo Pulsa into the side. Devo watching the opportunity. It's Remco, rather. He'll drop it down. Does not make contact. Corrupted G now. Sad Jr. up the linebacker position. The shot from Corrupted G was on target, but Remco's right where he needs to be. Perfect follow through. And now look at the transition here. Onto the backboard. Turbo Pulsa airborne. He'll drop it off the back of his car. And Devo will just fall back right now. They've got the lead. 1:22 left, possibly in Denial's Season 3 life. They have to score, they have to play like everything's on the line here. If they lose this, they go home. And Northern Gaming moves on in the bracket. Devo to wrap this one around. Turbo Pulsa looking, he'll rotate and allow Remco to move up. Getting it past the one Denial player, the shot goes around the two. And that one will not go through just yet, but final minute of game four, Denial has to score or they go home.
Can they pull it off? Right now, Northern Gaming seem to be getting confident, playing a lot more risky, but really successfully. Oh, Turbo! Devo almost getting another touch.
Now Remco watching. Continual follow up. The pressure from Northern Gaming, so much for Denial right now. They have to find a way to break out. We've seen them break through before and quickly on one shot manage to tie up a game. 30 seconds, plenty of time to make it happen, but they have to do it right now or they're going home. Sad Jr. on the side. He's just looking to gain ball control, but they're playing keep away so well. Northern Gaming not allowing that bump onto Corrupted G, continuing to put them out of position, but he manages to make it work in his favor. It's in the middle. Here comes Lethemir. The shot towards the net, saved by Turbo. And Devo with the follow through. Oh no, Sad Jr. Oh, that's not the way he wants it to go. All but sealing the deal here. Oh, that's got to be a heartbreaker for Canada.
That's got to be a frustrating way to end your season. I'm actually probably going to call this. 6 seconds left. I don't think it's going to be easy. Northern Gaming really just forcing Denial to turtle. They refused to let them out of their own half. They've finally figured out the weakness of Denial is that they didn't trust each other on defense. Will we see one more? No, it will get blocked away. The moment this touches, that will be it. Denial Esports, they are done here. They have been eliminated. They played so well. I think they surprised a lot of people here. And Northern Gaming, even though surprisingly dropping to the lower bracket, they will stay alive.
After game number one, it looked like there was a chance Denial would send the Dynasty home. But Northern Gaming bounces back three games straight, takes the win, and they will continue on. Well done to Denial as they came and they played their hearts out here, but they will end up going home here on day two. Northern Gaming playing like a team that's been here before, and they have such a storied history here at the LAN. They have finished third every time. They are still on the path to pull it off a third season in a row.
You know, people were talking about in scrims that Turbo was really, you know, playing out of his mind, and he's showing it right now. I think he was the top of the leaderboard most of those games. He's really showing Northern Gaming that he's not just a sub.
He scored at least 6 goals in this series. So much performance here from Turbo Pulsa. We saw him at Season 1. He missed Season 2's LAN, but he is shining in a way he never shone in Season 1 or Season 2 here on the Season 3 LAN stage.
And Denial just so close to being able to really pull off a lot of these games. It seemed like they really just didn't trust each other on defense a lot of times. I lost count of how many times 3 of them went for the same thing in net. They were all clumped up. No one was either up for a passing play to try and get the really quick, hard clears, and no one was really in the back to try and build up momentum. They all had almost no momentum. They were stagnant in net, trying to just bounce off saves, and eventually there's no doubt Northern Gaming's going to seal the deal.
And there was so much, such a lack of coordination on defense from Denial. We saw time and time again them not able to push it all the way through, but enough about them. I want to hear about Northern Gaming. I want to hear about Turbo Pulsa. Let's talk to Awesome Joey over on the stage.
All right, guys, got Turbo Pulsa here. And these guys were facing potential elimination here. That is really difficult to be playing in a position like that. How did you guys come into this game? What was your mindset coming into this must-win situation?
The only thing we thought about is winning. So that's all we thought about.
Okay, cool deal. So now, for your further matches, are you looking forward to any matchups at all, more than others, that you would like to see?
I definitely want to play Rogue, and we are going to, so it's going to be a fun match. The home crowd is against us, so it's going to be a great match.
Nice. So now you're saying the home crowd will be against you. Do you like to turn that into a positive thing, like where you're kind of like fighting from behind, or do you? Is it kind of weird when everybody's not cheering for you guys right away?
I'm not quite sure, to be honest. Yeah. I'm just... Thank you.
All right, so you guys gonna win it?
Yeah, of course. I hope so.
All right, sounds good, man. All right, well, you heard from Turbo Pussy. Great games, my man. We're gonna send it back over to Aklatos and the rest of the crew now. Thank you very much for being up here with us.
All right, thank you, awesome Joey. And I mean, come on.